Now, the Ghana Manganese Company is demanding results from government for an amount of $10 million it gave out to support the revamping of the Western Railway line to, among other things, enhance the haulage of their products. Now, the chief operating officer of the company, Benjamin Achukwashi, says 2 years after the support to government, not much has been done to fix the rail lines. Now, Mr. Kwashi, who was responding to questions during a visit by the Parliamentary Select Committee on Mines, said the company currently hauls about 90% of manganese by road, which costs $7 per ton, but would have cost $5 by rail. City News' Akwesini Ejeni has more.
Members of the Parliamentary Select Committee on Mines, led by the Vice Chairman, George Murikuduka, on day one of their two-day tour of mining companies in and around Takwa, visited three places including the Ghana Manganese, AngloGold Ashanti Iduapri Mines, and Goldfields Takwa Mines. The tour, which forms part of the oversight function of the committee, also had officials of the Ghana Chamber of Mines in attendance. The senior manager of AngloGold Ashanti Iduapri Mines, Stephen Asantiamua, briefing the committee, said they have increased their indigenous expenditure from 32% in 2015 to 56% in 2019 to help develop local companies. Mr. Yamua, while leading the committee around the mine, said although they are trying to expand their operations, communities nearby could pose a challenge to their plans.
The community keeps on expanding. And then our mine also is expanding. Unfortunately, the mine expands towards the western side of the pit, which is also towards the community. And the community is also increasing towards the eastern side, which is towards the mine. So as I speak to you now, the boundary between the mine and the community is just about 700 meters from the pit, from the operational area. Legally, we are supposed to operate within 500 meters, but we are operating just, we have put in some measures. We work with the municipal authorities, the Minerals Commission, the EPA, to make sure that we put a bit of constraint to the expansion of the communities.
At the Ghana Manganese Company, the chief operating officer, Benjamin Achukwashi, while responding to questions from the members of the committee on the impact of the haulage of manganese on rails, said it is even more expensive for the company to convey the product by road, hence their $10 million support to government towards the rehabilitation of the Western rail lines.
You see, if you look at our mode of haulage, it's about 90% by road. So I believe that if the railway line can be improved, that will go a long way to help us reduce cost and also take off the nuisance caused by the haulage trucks on the road. Ghana Manganese, realizing that haulage by rail is very important and the best way to haul our material from site to the port, did give Ghana government an amount of $10 million 2 years back to support the rehabilitation of the railway line. Unfortunately, to date, nothing concrete has been done to justify that expenditure. As we sit here now, the cost per ton to haul manganese from this mine to the port over the distance is $7. By rail is 5.9. So you can just do the math. If you are supposed to do about 7 million tons per year or 5 million tons per year, then you know how much you are putting into the haulage here in terms of extra cost. This is the picture I'm trying to paint.
A ranking member of the committee, Edward Bauer, who is also the MP for Bongo, told City News they would look into the concerns of the company.
I think that basically, as a company, I think it is in their interest to collaborate with government in trying to put down the necessary infrastructure, one, to reduce the cost of their own business, and also to help government in terms of the development of the country. So when you have a situation where $10 million has been given to a sector to rehabilitate part of the road, what do you call it, a railway, and we have not seen anything,